this, new details in the case of a home intruder stabbed to death. A stabbing in self-defense. Good evening, I'm George Mallet.
I'm Stephanie Gorin. An Essex Junction homeowner awakes to an intruder in his kitchen. It spurs a fight that leaves the intruder dead. Now, tonight, word from the county's top prosecutor that homeowner was indeed justified.
News Channel 5's Jill Glavin joins us live in the newsroom with more details in the case. Jill?
Well, George and Stephanie, this all started around 1 in the morning on June 1st when police officers pulled up to an Essex Junction home and found the homeowner holding down a man in his front yard. That man had 2 stab wounds and later died. Today we learned much more about how it all happened.
A caller reported that his father was outside screaming for help.
In the weeks since investigators combed the lawn outside this home in Essex Junction, one question has lingered. Should someone be held responsible for the man who died here? Now an answer.
I find Sean Garrett acted in self-defense and was justified in doing so.
40-year-old Sean Garrett, who owns an appliance repair business, told police he and his wife fell asleep watching a movie that night. Their 13-year-old was also asleep upstairs.
Garrett woke up to the sound he believed was the front door opening and closing, and as he awoke, he realized the kitchen light previously off was now on.
Police say that light was turned on by 30-year-old Ryan Morton Lane trying to rob the home.
He warned Garrett that I will kill you and made lunging motions with his hands towards Garrett, who felt the breeze of the motions as they passed by him.
It's that threat and a knife Morton Lane was known to carry that state's attorney TJ Donovan says prompted his decision not to charge Garrett. The homeowner told police he grabbed a paring knife and fought Morton Lane out onto the front lawn, but he doesn't remember the moment he stabbed Morton Lane in the heart, killing him. Still, Donovan said it all qualifies as self-defense.
Put simply, there is no evidence to support that Mr. Garrett was engaging in some type of vigilante justice, which clearly would not be tolerated.
This event has changed their lives forever.
Garrett's lawyer says the family is, of course, relieved, but still dealing with the effects of that night.
Many times you wake up in the middle of the night and there's a stranger in your house. That by itself would be traumatic enough, but then given the events that happened after this, it's been really tough on them.
Well, there was another case of a homeowner defending against intruders this month in Winooski. 2 suspects were shot. 1 remains in the hospital. That was also called self-defense. Still, Donovan said today this is not an invitation for homeowners to take up arms. And if at all possible, you should always lock your doors and call police for help, not take the law into your own hands. Live in the newsroom tonight, Jill Glavin, News Channel 5. George.